World is almost over because they have the mark of the beast in White House. Notice United States. They have the mark of the beast, that the Revelation chapter 13 verse 12 and 15 help us to understand that it's a worship issue. And also behind the scene, according to Revelation 13, behind the scene, the worship is the devil, friends. They a new world order. It's almost over. Notice, I'm going to repeat it one more time so that you can understand. The new world order, it's almost over. This is so-called the murder of church, Roman Catholic Church, the papacy. Notice, the Vatican, they the one, they infiltrate every countries, and they said they are president in every countries, friends. That's why they drawn the whole world money. That's one of the reason the whole world is in a financial crisis. And I want you to know this, because God explained this Bible prophecy clear. And behind the scene, like it says, it's going to be the mark of the beast, that the Bible says, friends. Bible never fails. So notice what Bible says. Revelation 13 verse 17. Notice. And that no man may buy or sell, save he that has the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Friends. And now let's read verse 15 and 16. Notice. And he has power to give the life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as will not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he caused all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bound, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. Friends, according to Bible prophecy, the first beast, and notice, just in case you don't understand the word beast, the beast, according to the book of Daniel chapter 7 verse 17, the Bible helps us to understand that the beast represent the kings. Friends, just in case you don't know, the mark of the beast is not computer chip, it's not tattoo, it's not all these worldly speculations that a lot of times you hear. Even sometimes some of the Christians, that they don't understand their Bible when it comes to Sunday churches. And a lot of Christians, they speculate. Friends, notice what Bible says. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 8. Notice. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thy hand, and they shall be as frontlet between thine eyes. And now let's go to the book of Hebrews. I'm going to help you to understand by the grace of God. Actually, God would help you to understand this Bible prophecy so that you can escape the mark of the beast, because we are living in emergency time, friends. Notice. This is coming from the book of Hebrews chapter 10 verse 16. Notice what Bible says. This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. Friends, God help us to understand that the mark of the beast, notice, the mark of the beast, it's in their mind. And remember what, you know, Moses says, according to the book of Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 8, that I just read it, between thine eyes is your forehead. Notice, it's the law of God, because the book of Deuteronomy, it's repeating the law. That's what the book of Deuteronomy is all about. So the test in the last days is the law of God, friends. That's what it's all about. Revelation 13 that I said before, it's the worship issue. And it's not computer chip, just like I said. Friends, it's the devil behind the scene. And according to the Bible, the law of God is a test when it comes to the Sabbath. The one that has the relationship, that, you know, God set it aside to, you know, use it to worship Him. It's a special day. That's what the Bible says. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. And according to biblical Sabbath, the true Sabbath is always Saturday. But the devil has his false Sabbath. That's why he used Constantine during 321 AD. Constantine changed God's holy Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday. Friends, you have to understand this Bible prophecy. And now we're going to go to Revelation chapter 13. Notice, Revelation chapter 13, you see two beasts. The first beast in Revelation 13 verse 1 to 10 is all about Roman Catholic Church, friends. Catholic means universal. Notice, that's why according to Revelation chapter 17 verse 15, you find out that this beast is universal. Notice, because it's controlling the world. But the second beast, notice, the first beast came out from the water. And the water represents multitude, nation, tongues, and people. I'm paraphrasing, notice. And that's what it says in Revelation chapter 17, verse 15. And this is the power. The first beast, Roman Catholic Church. Notice, during dark ages, they used to rule the world. But, you know, they're not gone. They're still in control. Now they're doing everything secret, behind the scene. People don't know. Like it says, they infiltrate almost everything. So notice, the second beast came out from the earth, some part of the earth. Notice, and you will find it from Revelation chapter 13, verse 11. Notice what Bible says. And I beheld another beast coming out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. Notice what it says in verse 12. And he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and caused the earth and those who dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. Friends, we know that the only country that they exercise all the authority of the first beast in his presence is the United States. Because United States, notice, Pilgrim's father, notice, they used to persecute them during dark ages. So they ran from persecution during 1620s. Notice, when they came United States, they find free land. But unfortunately, Revelation chapter 13 verse, notice, verses 12 to 17, United States will cause the whole world to worship the first beast, means Roman Catholic Church. And according to Bible, the Bible called this system, the Vatican, Roman Catholic Church, the one who's in control, means the one who's riding the horse, the beast. So if the Bible's called this power the beast, and the Bible says the mark of the beast, means this beast has a mark. Friends, and they are marked, they themselves, they says in their teachings, the book of catechism, notice, the old version, notice, they says Sunday worship is their mark of authority, because they the one, they changed the Sabbath. But thank God, even the new version, they don't use the word authority, but notice, at least they still admit it. They said they changed the Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday. And it's so sad that a lot of Sunday churches, Protestant, they are that for so